الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله تعالى فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. All praise be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we thank Him, we seek Allah's forgiveness, we seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's assistance, we seek and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase us in knowledge and bring us closer to Him. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us knowledge and gives us understanding of the purpose of our existence. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make every day bring us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make every day pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to make this life an increase for us in every goodness. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us live as a Muslim and die as a Muslim and be brought in the day of judgment with a Muslim. Ameen ya Rabbi Alameen. It seems like only a few days ago I said that 7 more Fridays for Ramadan. Wallahi, it seems like only a few days ago, but today I'm telling you it's only 3 more Fridays. This is how our life passes in front of our eyes. And the believers think and reflect and use wisdom to use the time. The most precious thing we have is time. One single second you can say Subhanallah, you can win a place in Jannah. One single second you can say Alhamdulillah, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said Alhamdulillah will fill the space between the sky and earth with good deed. Alhamdulillah tamda al mizan. Just saying Ya Allah, I'm so grateful, it will fill your record of good deed. We should appreciate the blessing Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala give to us. And in Ramadan especially, it's in 3 weeks and we need to prepare. We need to prepare. The Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ مَا رَمَضَانَ. If you know the reality and the goodness and the beauty of Ramadan, you will wish that the whole year is Ramadan. If you know what the beauty of Ramadan, you will wish that the entire 365 days is Ramadan. The Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to fast regularly, and so the Sahaba. Used to pray regularly for about 6 months before Ramadan. Ya Allah, please make us live to Ramadan. Why is that? There is two Sahabi, they became Muslim together. They became Muslim at the same time. One of them died a year before the other. A whole year before the other, but died in the battlefield. Died as a martyr. And this is like the highest place anyone can wish for. You're giving your life for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the second Sahaba, when he died a year later, they saw him in a dream that he is in a higher place in Jannah. They saw the second one who did not die as a martyr, died home in a better place, higher place than the one who died as a martyr. So they went to the Prophet ﷺ and said to him, how come? How come the one who died later, not a martyr, higher than the one who died as a martyr? He says, didn't he fast Ramadan? It can make a difference between being in the highest place in Jannah. As I said, Ramadan is the month Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose to send the Quran. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said there is 5 special gifts for the Ummah of Muhammad, only for the Ummah of Muhammad in Ramadan. 5 special gifts. The first one, that the smell that you have in the mouth because of not eating and not drinking during the month of Ramadan. You get the yucky smell. That is for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doing it. Allah will replace you with absolutely the most beautiful smell in the day of judgment. In Jannah, everybody will recognize you when you talk. Because you were from the fasting people of Ramadan. Because you were patient in that smell. You were patient in that suffering, and that dry mouth, and that dry throat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ. Whoever do an atom's weight of goodness, he will see it. And that is more than atom's weight. خَلُوفُ فَمِ الصَّائِمِ أَبْتِيَرُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ مِنْ رِيحِ الْمَسْكِ. The mouth smell of Ramadan, Allah will replace it with a smell that's better than any perfume you can ever imagine.
This is number one. Number two, the angels are making istighfar for you as long as you're fasting.
تستغفر لهم الملائكة حتى يفطروا.
The angels, those are closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making dua for us.
For 10, 12 hours fasting. Wallahi, it's something you have to prepare now. Wallahi, we have to prepare now. This is incredible. If you know that some rugby team coming to visit you, you will prepare now. Soccer team, not visit you. They will mention you once on their Facebook page. They will just mention you with, next to their shoes. And you will be saying, oh, Messi's shoes is sold for Egypt. Yeah? So, wallahi, what we're saying, what the Prophet Muhammad told us, it is worthy. It is worthy of us bringing it to our heart. Wallahi, I can't wait for Ramadan. I can't wait to pray. I can't wait to fast. I can't wait to do Taraweeh. I can't wait to read Quran. This is what the feeling is that we need to do for Ramadan. We have to prepare now. This is number two. So number one, Allah will give you the best meal in Jannah. Number two, the angels are making dua every single day of Ramadan. Number three, Allah is helping you out by chaining maradat al-jinn. Allah is restricting the movement and the planning and the temptation of the devil. That is helping for us to be able to do good deeds. And that's why you find it very easy in Ramadan to wake up and have suhoor and pray first. Very easy in Ramadan to go to the masjid and sleep for 2 hours. Very easy to pay donation and to make iftar. Very easy. Why? Allah's helping out. Allah's helping out. Number four, Allah's yuzayyinu Allahu lahumul jannah kulla layla. Every single night of Ramadan, Allah is beautifying your place in Jannah even more. Wallahi, we lose our mind if we think about it. Ramadan, every single night, Allah is beautifying your spot in Jannah. Your spot in Jannah? Yes, the Prophet Muhammad said, every single human being, when they're born, they have a spot in Jannah. And a spot in hell. That's the dangerous thing. You have to take it. And it's up to you to win. It's up when the angel of death comes. According to your deed, he will give you which one you want. Your name is there. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ticket to Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the best place in Jannah. So this Jannah spot is being beautified every single day. And number five, وَيَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ وَذَلِكَ آخَرْ لَيْنَ. Allah will forgive all your sins of your entire life. Think about it. Your entire life, 20 years, 30 years, 50 years of mistakes will be forgiven in Ramadan. The Sahaba just opened their mouths so high. I said, oh, is it Laylatul Qadr? Here, Laylatul Qadr. The Sahaba themselves were questioning, is it Laylatul Qadr? He said, no. This is not even Laylatul Qadr yet. This is just the payment. It's a payday. Once you do the work, you get paid. Same with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once you finish the work, you do the fasting, you get paid. What is the payment? Forgiveness. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, As-salawatu ila salawat kaffara lima baynahuma. Between the salat, 5 daily prayer, it forgives all your 4 hours, 5 hours before. Wal jum'a ila jum'a kaffara lima baynahuma. Friday to Friday, it forgives the week's mistakes. Ramadan, ila Ramadan. Ramadan forgives the whole entire year instead. So it is something to be ready for. It is something to prepare for. It is something not to really be complacent and not to take it for granted and not to use it as a habit. It's not a habit. It is something that is a religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we need to feel the greatness and the blessing that Allah chose us from the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because if we were not, we will never have known about Ramadan. We will never know about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We will never know about the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Ramadan is the month of Quran. Ramadan is the month of Taraweeh. We must have the intention to die. Because if we die before Ramadan, Allah will give us the reward of the intention. You know that? If you today in your heart, in your mind, say, Ya Allah, of course, till I die, I will do every Ramadan properly. I will do every Taraweeh properly. If you die before that, Allah will give you the reward, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you the reward once you do the intention. If you do it, He times 10. He gives you 10 times the reward. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us all rich Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it the best Ramadan for us and our family. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the energy and the health and prosperity to witness this Ramadan and many, many more Ramadan. And make us reason for happiness and help to all our brothers and sisters in the community and the Muslim Ummah. أَقُولُ قَوْلِي هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ لَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوا. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على حبيبنا رسول الله. Ramadan is the month that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose for us. Ramadan is the month of dua. Ramadan is the month of dua. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that there is some people their dua will never be rejected. As-sa'im hatta yuftar. The fasting person till they break their fast. You have 10 hours of open, absolutely open policy to make dua and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the goodness of this life and hereafter. Make your list today. Make your list today because you cannot make it in Ramadan. Make your list today. Include everything. Wallahi, some of us forget about our mothers, forget about our fathers, forget about our children. We don't make dua for them. We have no time. But if you prepare and make a list now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will listen to us and answer us in Ramadan. Ramadan is the month of dua. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. Allah says, ask me and I will answer you. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الدُّعَاء هو العبادة. Dua is ibadah. Asking Allah is an act of worship. Crying and singing, Allah, please help me. Ya Allah, give me a good job. Ya Allah, give me a good house. Ya Allah, give me a good education. That is a good thing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Ramadan is the month of dua. Ramadan is the month of charity. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ana wa kafir al-yateen ka'atayn. The one who sponsors, the one who looks after the orphan, the needy, will be with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannah. Imagine that. Ramadan is that month. So we have to plan to. There is no poor people in New Zealand. Everybody complains. There is no orphan in New Zealand. Okay, there's orphan in Somalia. There's orphan in Syria. There's orphan in Fiji, in Egypt. Today you send the money. Today you send it and talk to somebody and say, here's 100 iftar for 100 family. Here's $1,000. Buy the food now. Book it now and every night in Ramadan. And it has to be every night in Ramadan. You send the money and say to them, give it to 100 family and give $10 every night. You're done. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept from you. It is the month of generosity. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كان أجود ما يكون في رمضان. He was the most generous, especially in Ramadan. Ramadan is the month of keeping check in what we say, in our manners, in our morals. Ramadan is not about stopping food and drink only. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من لم يدع قول الزور والعمل به فليس لله حاجة أن يدع طعامه وشرابه. Whoever doesn't change in Ramadan, whoever Ramadan doesn't change them from lying and mocking and being arrogant and showing off, Allah doesn't need his fasting. Allah doesn't need your ibadah. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I will guarantee you, look at this hadith, I will guarantee you a house in Jannah. A house in Jannah. Ana za'im bi baytin fil Jannah. Liman taraka al mira wa in kana muhiqqan. Those who don't argue, even if they are right, even if they have a point, even if they have a point, fasting comes to teach us to fast from arguing. The Prophet Muhammad said, you win a house in Jannah when you not argue, arguing with the wife, arguing with the children, arguing with the mom. You stop because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is like it. Even if you're right, even if you have a point, the Prophet guarantees you a place in Jannah. And he says, and I guarantee you a better place, a nicer house in Jannah for those who don't lie. Man taraka al-kadhib wa in kana maziha, even in a joke. Even by joking and kidding around, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you don't lie, I'll guarantee you a better place in Jannah. And I guarantee you a house in the best place in Jannah. لِمَنْ حَسُنَ خُلُقَهُ. The third one, the best one, for those with a good akhlaq, good manners. Gentle, kind, soft, honest, sincere, helpful. That is what Allah is looking for from Ramadan for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the best akhlaq. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us honesty. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us sincerity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us kind and gentle and honest and sincere to each other. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill our heart with love and respect to each other. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring peace and tranquility and success to our homes, our families, to our community. Inna Allah wa malikatahu salluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli wa sallimu barik ala nabiyyika Muhammad. Allahumma a'inna ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husna ibadatik. Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. اللهم بلغنا رمضان اللهم بلغنا رمضان وبارك لنا فيه وعنا على ذكرك وشكرك واستعاذك فيه. اقول قولي هذا استغفر لكم فاستغفروه واقم الصلاه.